guys, hindi welcome ngayon sa channel natin. So andito tayo ngayon sa Studio 300 dito sa Pasig. So yun guys, waiting lang tayo dito. Medyo napaga tayo eh. Bago tayo umalis kasi umuulan. So yun guys, dito na tayo sa labas. So may seminar tayo kay Coach Bob Salvacion, License A, PFF. So yan, wait natin sila dito guys, okay? Buksan tayo eh.
Opo.
Na? Games pay per year, yan. Yung bola, size 4-4 ako. Pagdating sa 13, tandaan nyo palagi.
Na nagpa-five.
Size 5 na yan, 4-5.
Size 4 oh, and 5.
Size 4 lang.
Oh. Oh.
Kasi alam ko yung 7, size 5 na eh.
12, pagdating sa 12.
Pabigat na yung paa niyan, no?
Kasi may impact to sa development.
Tapos, yung concern ko lang dito, ito 7v7, yung 12. Yung 12, tingnan nyo, 7v7.
60 na. Na opo, 60 na.
Tako nyo, 60 by 40.
Opo.
O 30 by, ako mas maliit pa nga dito, 50 by 35, pwede na eh. Ito, yung 13, 9v9 siya, hanggang hinahinay
hanggang ka na 11v11. Mag, hanggang ba, mag, bago mag 11v11, coach.
How do you see that? Transform into 11v11.
Opo. To big space, coach, no?
Pag 7, small 7 space. Versus 7, tapos i-11 mo, parang hindi siya dumaan sa 9
na. Pag-usapan natin. Pero I don't think we can take up all these things, eh.
Because yung mahalaga lang.
Really? Summary.
Anyway.
Yung kailangan matutunan.
Ito, dapat alam dito, explain, demonstrate, practice, feedback, back to practice. Pero I don't think, diyan sa foundation phase ito. So yung foundation phase natin, yaman, 11 to 13. Although, 40 by 30. So maliit lang yan.
In size.
Okay. 10 minutes to 30 minutes. O ilang games yung ginihingi niya sa year? 25. 20. So halos every other week. Diba? Dapat ang size ng bola, 3 lang. Lang.
3
hanggang U9. 10.
Hanggang 10. U10.
Okay. 3 lang yung size. Ball pa rin, ha?
3 lang, no?
Diba? Tapos U6 na U7,
5v5.
Opo. Okay. U8, 5v5, 5v5.
So, 3 pa din, no?
So, okay lang
sa yung elementary 3v3. Kasi 5 na nag-start.
But you have to look at also the capabilities ng bata.
Ng players,
physical
yes,
abilities
po.
Ng bata.
Opo,
physical
opo.
Abilities niya.
Then, kung mental
capacity. You don't just look at the skill.
Okay.
Then, yung length of exercise or yung length of
consideration is what particular each group or team, probably under 16, probably within next team, probably ASCAL or probably Malditas, whatever, no? Or under 6 years old, GE, or under 12. Then, next is what I am going to train or to practice. Shall I practice technique? Shall I do fitness? Shall I do tactic? Or set pieces or whatever? Based on your previous observation. It's you who can decide what to practice. When? You see when? Kailan? Kailan is when? Kailan?
Yeah.
When is time for the day? The day. When is at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, at 7 o'clock in the evening, or early morning, whatever. That depends. So consideration is the rain, the sun, every condition. Where I am going to practice? That is senior probably the word where in the pen inside the penalty area middle turn attacking turn or we start from the border where can be in gymnasium can be in big pitch in Makini or small area in Olave. Those are some considerations. Again, technical ability is of your player, children, all the six in that consideration. And why? Why do you practice? Why do you need to plan? To what? What is the very objective of the training or the practice?
Development.
To what? To improve performance to improve technical abilities or skills or tactics or to improve set pieces or whatever. That is who are the players? Next, consideration the following. I already mentioned that. You must. Then try to. Try to what? Consider the developmental and the competitive. If you say competitive, is what?
Aggressive. Fight on to others.
Of course.
To challenge.
Not developmental, not competitive. Developmental is what? The younger ones, yes. The small ones, no? The new ones, no? A new player who just come into the piece and you want to play football because mama, daddy, you want to play football. You want to play football. But the 15 are those who are already both or she's one players. But still we have to train to improve more.
That's good.
Alright. Number of players. You know that already, just the anatomy. Fitness level. And then there are some problems sometimes that may arise. In your training, simply because of communication or language. Some don't understand English. Some don't understand Tagalog. So you have to do Tagalog in English. Or some cannot understand more. Or sometimes me, myself, like me, I'm not really. So you may set aside, I'm not understanding all the time. So, it's your language, so it's sad. So it's English, so it's, but anyway, you put we speak the same language. As universal saying, right?
That's good.
When I know you know I'm going to kick the ball. Right? When I go there, you're going to drop the ball, what? Alright. You know, Moses, don't be intimidated, don't be ashamed. If you want to ask questions, just interrupt me, just raise your hand like
that. That's good.
Alright, so we can help you and then we can help you. What are the training objectives? One of the most important considerations in your planning of training. What will be your objective? My last question. What will you train? 8 years old or 10 years old? What will be the consideration? And you want that really will be started for 6 months or 1 year. What will be the first consideration? The very, very consideration. They practice regularly, at least twice a week or twice a week. What will be your priority? No one. Give me an idea.
Three times?
What? Because when that particular group are practicing, that's technical. So the ball and the
ball.
The player and the ball. And a small space of 10 by 15 to 20. That depends upon the number. If they are just ball, you can use only 15 or 20 square or a rectangle. I think a small goal or some sort of markers. The disc or the post.
Yeah, yeah.
When you said markers, here, I think it's important. Markers, you see markers in this.
Cone.
What about this? Cones. No, cone. they are all markers.
Markers.
The one is cone.
Cone.
Type. The other one is the disc.
Disc type.
Right. There, fall.
Thank you.
Don't stress the players. Technique and coordination. The physical is coordination. Technique is step over, cross over, that like dancing, you know?
Yes.
Sometimes you don't do it. You do it and you keep talking to one another. You enjoy football, that's good. That's a sign of good. Relationship between the players and the coaches. Skills for the youth, you have to what? Skill, then the positional thing. Body position, angle of the body towards the man with the ball, distance, short, right? You understand?
Good.
So you also what? Introduce the group tactics. Like what team introduced last practice, for example. He introduces that depending in a 1v1 situation. Okay, from head to foot. So I have to go in elaborate. Eye on the ball, right?
That's good.
1 foot in front, 1 foot behind. But no, hand straight to good. To have good balance and the foot must not be too close or too wide to maintain your
balance.
Good balance. Okay. Never to square, always go like that. When you switch left to right, you have to be very fast or very quick. Those are the foot points where depend. Number one, eyes on the ball. But you know, right? Next is what? Hands spread if possible. Because why? Because you're going to measure the opponent. You don't attack or tackle the opponent or commit the opponent when you are away from the distance. Well, probably that depends upon the ocean. If I am, she's taller, who's taller than me?
Games.
The distance James can give is different from the distance I can. Because I am only 5'6", I think. How tall are you, James? So here, is this the tackling distance? Here, yeah.
Yes.
But for James,
it's big.
It's different. So don't tell them, one yard, 15, 1 yard, but he is tall. So he can even give 1 yard in something. You just say what? Tackling distance. All right, James, can you have to what? Because now he's in the ball. All right, so I am drinking. So he, I go in. I do that crossover, they will be the outside of the number one. So, can anybody coach teams?
Yeah.
I'm on the ball.
Who was a ball coach?
I'm number 9. He's number 4, number 5, whatever. So, can somebody coach him? Coaches, you have to be very sharp. I said, I what?
Eyes on the ball.
Eyes on the ball. Then?
No, 1 foot.
Body low.
1 foot forward.
Coach him.
Arms up. Arms forward.
Arms out.
Yes.
But the body shape is
easy. He might happy. Wow. Rest is easy. So 1 foot forward, 1 foot in front, 1 foot.
Bend your knees. Yes.
Engage. Right.
The distance.
Starts. One arm.
So we need to like that. Alright.
Start.
So you have you already have the idea. We like seeing that block take the news. Coaches, you have to be very observant in the things. Somebody's talking, somebody's running. Because you are coaches. You are not just teacher, but you are coaches. Your eyes is always everywhere. Diba? Sinasabi, we said that. Just look up to your eyes, look up to your shoulder, you see everything. Alright?
It's good.
Okay, course for adults, we use what? If we want to develop that, starting to win. There. Mental toughness, of course, do we train that? Do we include that in our training? If possible, 12 years old, 11 years old, 10 years old, do we?
Yes.
There are players, there are boys or girls, sometimes you just fall down and then you stay there for, you don't mind them, but you have, that's why I tell you, your eyes should be focused on what you are. To do. Like Miguel, no? He loves to, especially if he's not around. Maybe? So don't mind him. But you must understand, you must know how he felt in the ground. Sometimes nothing happened. Sometimes yeah. Something happened. Alright, any question? We go, we cannot.
Okay.
You cannot stay on. Let's go. Iron, please. When was the season take place? Because this trip is FIFA and EFC, no? So it's international stuff. Probably before the season or pre-season. It's pre-season. We have two. Close. And what? Malapit na ba? It's close. The season. So what do you do? Far from the season. Probably a month or 2 months ago or before the season. Or during the season or in season or mid season or the season is about to end or sometimes the very hard things to do when the season is about to finish. Why? Because sometimes professional players don't play that much because they are going to transfer to another club. Design something like that so you can no longer utilize those players that much. The health is no longer holding that success. Alright, and then the end of the season, or how do you call that? How do you tell that? After the season is end,
off
season. So what do you do off season? Smoking cigarette, you know. Hey, hi! Transfer and 30 million, blah, blah, blah. I'll be working with Ronaldo, no? Alright. But the base of the season time is the development of competitive or competitive developmental or you know what, the son that already is then this was self-district, this is not a Tony. Hindi ako makakita. So, that will be the determinant of your activity. It is fitness, tactical, technical, or athletic. So you have to be on track of what's going on with your team. And you have a good connection with your assistant coaches. Then your trainer. Remember what the coach provide one in this piece?
He
talk about the team within the team. Okay? All those are under you when you are the coach, the master, the fitness coach, the whatever things you have there. Even the ball boys and the team man. Okay, so where will be the
session take place?
The session will take place, or the season will take place? Local, international, or in Mulabe, or in Betor,
Alabang,
BGC,
Alabang, Alabang, or in Ihaglo. We have to come to the time of that beautiful beach, beautiful grass, beautiful beach.
BSM.
Yes.
Chinese school. Chinese school.
Alright. Where will be the season to be held? Outdoor? Why outdoor?
Probably
with this only. Strength only for 6 years old. Do you know that?
No.
When do you start doing that? Strength conditioning with apparatus only.
16.
When they are already 15, more than 16 years old.
Yeah.
But it should be controlled. Not allow them to go there. The first thing we're going to do is to
bodybuilder.
Huh? Alright.
Muscular.
Indoor, futsal.
What's in the CV?
We do that in the restaurant. So, what do you need to solve? You can put self-help, promote development, technical development for the regular players to pitch. Yes. Because of what?
Passing.
Yeah, because of constant confrontation of what we want. Passing, moving, transition. Depending to attacking. Goalkeeper, gets the ball, you have to be ready because there is what?
Time.
A lot. You have to release the ball. So, players keep on moving. And moving. And make decision. Again and again. There is no time for you to recover sometimes. Alright. Close doors. So you keep yours right there. You practice without media, you practice without anybody except you. Because you're playing against Manchester United with against Sir Alex Pulido. Who's the coach now of that? Who's the coach of Manu?
Manu.
How is the team right now? We went running on the track. Why do you run on the track? Why do players, football players on the track? For what?
Conditioning.
Probably
fitness.
Endurance. The track along with the dimension of it. You have
fitness.
Start with that endurance. How do you gain fitness? Not for a only for basketball or football or volleyball or whatever sports. You have to develop first of all. Endurance.
Endurance.
Then strength. Then flexibility.
Flexibility.
Conditioning.
Then you go to
condition.
Speed. And then you go to what next? Technical. Without the core, you can't develop the skills. So there are 5 S. Number one is what? Stamina.
Stamina.
Or endurance. Number two is strength.
Strength.
Number three is what? Flexibility or suppleness. Number five is what? Speed.
Speed.
And number last is the speed.
Skill.
Without those, you cannot develop the speed. I mean, you cannot perform. Alright? Thank you, guys. What?
Of course.
Overseas, on rating goals, it's a weird little thing. There are two things, no? You play here or you play outside. And when you're playing outside, you're bringing in Ascal, you are the head coach. The first thing you're going to do is what? Familiarization, right? For the head coach. Then, at the same time you're doing that, acclimatization. There are two things, huh? Acclimatization and acclimatize. To differentiate. Alright? Just review it. I cannot elaborate that much more here. Alright? So, adapting to that environment, like you're going to Russia or Ukraine. Okay. Well, there's what? Why I am doing these things? What? To prepare my team for competition, to improve performance. That's why I coach. Now, if you answer the last thing there, you read it, try it.
If you have valid answers to such questions based on scientific and developmental principles, then you are on the right track.
Okay, what I want to do, I want to emphasize on the scientific. There always basis for the things why you are doing. Like sometimes it becomes philosophy. Things that you do believe that you keep doing it again and again because you think the things that you are doing is right with scientific basis. You don't just see something without science or basis of science. Do you follow? Do you understand?
Yes, coach.
Can we go on? Any question?
No, coach.
Can you give me other tips for planning the session? I have. There's a beautiful girl in the side that planned with me. So I can impress the lady there on the side. Right? Because something is like that. We have umbrella, we have Ray-Ban, Cigarillo. Hey, boys! She was still there, in the same course. Then we met again when I enrolled in sports science in private university. So, they were there. But she's a very nice girl for up to now. She gave us tickets for everything. For science. Okay. Here. I do not try to. Can we get very popular? I asked Coach Simon about that in can adopt that. We can change. I am open for the change because that's not necessary. I get that from, I don't know, I think it's BGs or something, long, long time ago. Can you? Yeah, so when you will be, when you're doing your plan, you want to be guided with that. With your name, the date, the topic you're going to frame, alright, you know, the team that you have here, J8U11 or J8U13, whatever, for girls, and then we have assistant, and then the topic will reflect your objective. Kibawa, passing, so, o kaya, heading. So there's nothing more than is to what? Improve or develop heading technique. Or develop
dribbling.
Heading in attacking. Or to develop heading when defending. Things like that. Alright? Probably, Paul Simon will come, what is your topic? Let's see what I mean. So you also don't want to. Why we don't we want that? Because I want you to keep that in your file as host. So you can assist yourself, you can ask yourself after a month what I have done during your past week in the training. Did you train for this? Did you train for that? Alright. So here is complete. The name of the host, the assistant of the assistant coach, the topic, the number of players you're going to have. What if you only have 2 players or 3 players come? You are expecting 8 or 6 or whatever, 10 or 3. Less than 3. Sometimes you expect 12 players and they come 15 or 13 or 22. So you have plan A and plan B. Those five months. So you have to be weak, it says you have to be very flexible. Well, you have to be, you should adapt to what is. That's why I make with the, I mean, where's the house of Paul Simon is sending you also the
form?
I mean, even at 12 o'clock, because I have, sometimes, in the middle of the day, I was preparing to drive my motorcycle, going to the practice, deciding, check me, another, so, I have to sit down with my mom. So when I arrive there, I already memorize. So that's how I live in coaching. Because I am not that good. There's no good. There's no badness. There's nothing to possess. There's one part of that life. Alright? No matter how good you are, you don't have the materials, you don't have the support, you don't have anything. But your skill to be good. Right? Forget about the people around you, forget about the people who criticize you, that is part of your life. You said that you cannot go, you said you cannot never, literally, never say something. But I mean, the other people say that people criticize you. That is the challenge around us. Because there is no permanent in coaching.
Can I have okay?
That's good.
Alright?
That's good.
Sometimes you will be appointed. Sometimes you will be removed. Yeah. You will be changed. That is our nature. Okay. Here. See the light.
Okay.
So here.
Take
a picture. We see the process. Plan, because the topic is plan, right? And then explain or brief your player what will be the training, the objective to improve passing in the midfield, for instance. And then you organize the area, play in it, man. Don't go there right away. Stay on the side. to say Riyan, then explain to them what will be the objective. Who will be involved? How do you serve? What are the restrictions and everything there? Alright?
That's good.
And then, demo. Demonstration. Do it again. Demo again. And ask questions. There you go, question and answer. Do you understand? Can you do it? And he said, yes. Okay, so we start. Anyways, okay, we start. Start right away. Then what do you do? Observe. 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 Then you should be very observant of what's going on. So every individual place be observing. Now, if you have partner, you're doing the things. This is the working area. You have to cooperate with one another. If he goes that way, you have to move that way. So your assistant in you be moving. How do you say that? It's going left, you're going right. So you meet each other.
Synchronized.
Right? You met one, then the two times you met. You have to ask question. Okay na ba? Pwede na, mati. One is not doing that. Oh yeah? Who else? Ramon? Okay. So you have to address the problem. You identify the problem. Then you stop the practice and explain to them. Now, most of them are made committing mistake or the same mistake, you must stop the practice. Alright? Stop the practice. Stop! Then what? Explain to them what is things to be done. Demo? If you cannot demonstrate, let somebody do the demonstration. Then go back immediately to the practice. Right? Then observe again. That's the cycle. And then now, if only one or two, only me and Simon is committing mistake, don't stop the whole thing. Come to him or come to me. Why are you not doing it? Because you get my girl. Did everything. Okay? No. Only address the two of them. Don't address the whole team with their mistake. You understand? One of you. Right? If you see them again, doing the same. For what reason? Probably they are not mentally ready. No? I have a boy who is very challenged with his boy. Math. But now he is trying to. But his spirit is always there, he wants to win, but he didn't just run, he just had to go the back. I like the boy. See, Rapa now, his Rapa is doing well. I can just move that much. But I think he has bigger. Alright. So, that is the cycle. Again, huh? Plan, right, based on what you observe on your last training session or the what you have last week. Then explain, organize the area. I explained to you a while ago. Then show the practice. They move there. Start the practice, observe, observe, observe. Here are some mistakes coming from the coaches. You allow it, okay? In less than a minute, or just a second, stop! Why are you doing it? Allow them to be, allow them to explore for a while, but note down the scene. Let them at least 2 minutes. 1, 2, 3 minutes we do. Then we start. Alright?
Good.
Those are some little mistakes that means a lot. Allow them to explore. Don't disturb them. Then if you remember, we are coaching small kids. We are not coaching professionals. even the professional have to allow them. Because sometimes it's hard to help. Okay, by leading them, you know? Sometimes it could help. Even Messi, Ronaldo, commit mistakes. Yes. Controlling, passing, whatever.
Finishing.
So allow him to rest. Feel that environment for you. Stop. All right. Thank you. We will be next topic. You want to move?
Thank you, guys. 2 minutes break. Vodka. Yeah. Coach Yolo.
Ano yan? Sa San Bea sa asawa para proof na
nandito. Oo,
siyempre. Oh, pamaya naman yung girls nandito.
5 minutes later.
Okay, that's it. Well, we take the coaching and the coaching principle of teaching it. Coaching. How do we differentiate teaching to coaching? Very simple question. Very simple question. I teach, I don't care if you learn, I intend to understand. At 12 o'clock, I'm done. In coaching, it will affect me. If you don't, got that?
Okay.
Why? Because it will affect my performance as a coach and the team as well. So that's the difference. The will, in my own personal opinion. The teacher can just go 15 days, he got the salary. 20, he got the salary. He realized to learn or not. But in coaching, no. You will be fired by the management.
Let me come out.
Do you follow? So now, here, who is this boy? You have. Your son? Jolo? Or the side man? How old is he?
I think he's big now.
Yeah. Alright. Your major aim, your objective in coaching, teaching, better what?
Performance.
If you are number 7 in the league or in the table, you want to be number 1, if not number 2, 3, but you have not, you have to get out of number 7, or else. Alright, to change the attitude. How do we change the attitude of our team? By believing in what we are doing. So there's a lot of things that you have to do. You challenge them, you encourage them. You challenge them again, encourage them. Until such time that they are to do. And you, we as coaches, with other coaches, with your trainers, with your mask, in everything else, especially the players. In our case, in the small piece that we are handling, if you don't have patience, you start with any coaching. Sometimes you coaching here, you only have 11 players in your training, but the thing is, there, one is there, the other one is there, the other one is in that. We're doing it something else. Alright? So if you cannot handle that, come on, it's normal for us. You have to scratch your head again. Good thing you have assistant. We work with assistant. Or you work as assistant. In our time, the host is only one. Sometimes he is not really a host, he's just the same senior among us, and He's the boss. He has the ball. Sometimes 50 of us, I have guys around. Now, if you have only one ball, and you have the big pitch in Balotang Nuevo, and you have 30 boys, what will you do? Answer me. What? You allow him to play. Hey, you there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 10 of you there. 10 of you there. Oh, wait. The 10 of you. Goalkeeper, you. Play the game. No more exercise, no more passing, no more. Play the game. After 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes. Stop!
Change.
What's the score? This team. Skin and shirt. Huh? Skin out! Of you. Skin. Skin. Don't forget about that. Exercise one, exercise two, progress one, and this is two. No, wait. Sorry. Alright? So, you just have to adapt. But, not only you can adapt, you have also to prepare. So, knowledge should be there at all in that time. Aim in that time. For better application. When you apply what we have, you cannot give what you don't have. Right? Can I give million to Coach Simon? No, I can't. Miko probably. Three.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay,
enough. I need to take pesos later and I charge you 25 pesos for the same. Huh? All right. How do young players play? How do they learn? By playing? By what? By your guidance, by your coaching, by your teaching. Without two. Yeah. Nowhere to go. Football, eh? We talk about football here. Alright! Any question? You might not understand. I presume that you understand that you have everything that I have telling you. Play under you guys. Okay. Here, I have to ask this question. How many young players there? By what?
Motivation.
Sometimes that number one is already present. True motivation and interest. Especially the boys, 11 years old and 12 years old. They already have that. They are the most easy to handle children. That particular age, the under 12, even up to 13. Remember that. But we become 13 after the first adolescent stage. You will have a problem will arise. We'll start. Alright. Enthusiasm. How? How can you be? How can you be? What? By what? By challenging them. By motivating them. Good. Very good. Excellent. But sometimes you say excellent. Because if you said excellent, there will be more progress. That's the highest level of degree of accomplishment. Alright? Have been good model. Are you a good model? To tell you frankly, coach, what's he going on? What's he going on late? Why are you coming late? How can you be a good model? Me? Sorry, ah. Mag-piss. I punished him with three that night. So they understand that time is very essential, very important for you. But you yourself, to be a good model, okay, you do what you preach. Don't tell me. You cook your favorite menu, but you do it yourself. Listen. So when it comes to time, good afternoon, sir, Migo. When it comes to time or punctuality, there will be no compromise on this. I tell you, don't compromise anything. You've been the small kid, why were you late? But you had to ask questions, don't tell it. Jack Knight, press up. No, you can't. you have to give him reason. The reason all the time is my mother. But still again, okay, it's okay, but do just right. The thing is, he knows that when he came late, he will be
punished.
Right. At best. Okay, having good models, opportunities. What? Here again, you have to have the good knowledge to give them good opportunities to play football, to dribble, with your guidance, to shoot. Prophetically, what I invite to them, you emphasize palagi the highest level of performance. Why one? Putting it in something that children. To attain higher standard. You see, higher standard is what? It can be what? National, not only inter-school or inter-club, but
international
scouts. Or even a club in America or in Europe or in South America. We can do that. We can compete with those countries or with those clubs in our level. The under 8, the under 10, under 12, even 13. But 13, 14 will be hard. 16 it will be very hard. Why? Some of the European players, South American players at the age of 15, they already signed. Because of football in other countries. Right? We the Philippines, we want only one. But very big. All right, so that is the challenge that we're facing right now. Okay. Feedback. What do you mean by feedback? Coming from that, or coming from other coaches, or coming from your colleagues, or coming from the parents. When there's negative feedback, all right? Don't fight it. Absorb it. Think about it. Do something about it. Don't get down. I can do nothing anymore. No. That's good. But try again. Try again. Try again. Try again. Get down. Open. Okay, support and encouragement. You have to support them. You have to encourage them regardless of the score. Because at that particular stage, up to 14, you need encouragement, you need your support, they win what they lost. Alright? You challenge them. You win, you challenge them. Can you do better? Can you do better? Can you improve the past? Alright? Can you come early? Don't wait for the ball? That's how you move. Challenge your. But provided that what you're telling is doable. He can do it, but he can. You know that he can do it. Forget about it. Don't even think about it. Any question? Any God, this is how to go fast. I'm sorry. I don't know. So he talks about fitness. The young players need to be fit. He need to have developed technique. Even skills, but how do we transfer that from our knowledge, from our experiences? Fitness, what are the basic fitness of the children? Balance, agility, don't ask for sprint, jump, 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 and run sprint, no, forget about it. Okay, do ball, and then dribble fast with the ball, turn fast with the ball. Do that, step over, cross over with the ball. That is the common things that you see, you watch in the television, when you watch a professional football. You understand? Controlling with any part of the body, the chest, the head, the thighs, and everything, even the soul, the foot, even the sin of the body. So you have to develop that. Release of some technical skill, yeah, I have said already. Some attitudes and character things. Some attitude. How do you develop that attitude? Some attitude then. How do you develop that as a coach? I want to answer my question. Anybody? Brian? Provide me with that. I answer your question because we. But if you want it, okay? Praises. Huwag ka mag-tipid doon. Don't be say praise it for everybody. Tap yung the shoulder. Again and again. Love. Alright? He said, though the door cross over, he tried but he failed. It's okay. That's very good. Right? Because he tried it. The bad thing is he don't do it. But once he tried, you have to praise it. Alright, knowledge and understanding of what you are doing. You must know what you are coaching or teaching the children. If you don't know them, how do you say that? In Ilongo? Kailing, how do you say that in Ilongo? Pagkakaka ka lang. You don't know what you are. You do not know your teaching. As I said before, you agree with me that there will be all this science behind your philosophy, behind your things you do. Yes, Lolo.
Yeah.
Right? Okay? From grooming for personal appearance to your disposition as a coach. Any question?
Yeah, coach.
Please, are you okay? Okay, so. Teach. But how can you teach if you don't know that? Football, if you don't have the knowledge. You can't. So what do we do as coaches? We go like this. We study. We read. We listen. We ask questions. Alright? We watch the games.
Yes, coach.
Do you follow? Because we cannot say something which we don't have.
Yes, coach.
To be knowledgeable, you have to expose yourself in a lot of things, as I said. Studying, listening, asking questions, attending seminars and courses, and so on. And then knowledge of how people learn. The same thing, no? You cannot manage or you cannot help people when you don't know what to do. How do you manage the children under 8, under 10, under 12? No, what Simon put you there under 18 or under 6? What will you do? The sudden change or if you don't have that. So you have to what? To understand the peculiarity of every individual age. Because under 6, under 8, 10 is different from under 14, under 16. You know that?
Say.
Mental or psychological ripple of every individual. Because if you don't, then you get it. Inspire. How do you inspire? Very good. Races again.
Lollipop.
Doing things, you know? Doing the demonstration. Sometimes you want to do the demonstration, but you can't do it anymore. So let somebody do the demonstration for you. Alright? What do you think can do the demo? Okay, if you going to encounter that particular kind of demo, you say more than 30 minutes, like outside of the food. And then, change of direction, so then you have to come to the practice area. Ngayon, mamaya ikaw mag-demo. Later, you will be the one to demo. Ha? Together with Ryan. Ryan. Alright? So, you empower them. And for them, that's good. For them, that's just an achievement because they are asked to do that demonstration to lead. But don't expect too much from them. You have to do your inspired results of quality performance, demand for quality performance, like past with the start. That's always the case in the under 10,
yeah.
Under 12. Because they are not used to. Sometimes they cannot adapt right now. Like we are practicing for 1 year or something, in 1 year, you don't even know how to throw the ball. Same thing, you don't have that in more of it. They cannot pass and then run. They pass the goal, the 1-2, they have problem with that. Because it's too small, too short for them to execute those speeds or anything. So again, you challenge them again. Demand quality performance, but you have to guide them when to run, how to run, and where to run. What is sense running in front of the ball, running the yellow line?
Run.
All right.
Yes, Judge.
Next, delivery logical sequence. What is that? That is consequent. Like you did a while ago, when you are depending against the opponent in a 1v1 situation wherein your head or your eyes should be focused on the ball. Because if you can't see the ball, you can't defend. Hands should be
right
on your side or on your
front
of the back to put you back, to keep you in balance. Put 1 foot forward, 1 foot in front, 1 foot behind, not too close, not too
wide.
To also maintain good balance, yes, and flexibility. When I say flexibility in this picture, I can do like that, yeah? I can do like that. I can shift from left to right. I put my left foot in front, I can actually put my right foot in front. Because I am in good balance. Okay?
Yes,
so, do you follow?
Yes, coach.
Logical instincts. So, maintindihan na natin ha, don't jump. If you do it from head, go to the foot last. If you do it from the foot, you do it from the, you finish with the upper body. It's just like what? Stretching after the session. Do the stretching like that, then all of a sudden you do like that. From head to foot. From head to the toes. Or from toes to the
head.
After a patient, persistent, enthusiastic. What is the word persistent?
Patient.
Yeah, patient. That's one.
Patient.
Determined. That you do believe on what you are doing. Because you what? You do what? Study. You do what? Research on things like that. Coaching, teaching is knowing what you are teaching and knowing who you are coaching. If you can connect with him, no matter how good the idea you have, you can. The same thing, no matter how you know him. But if you don't know, you don't have the knowledge of what you are teaching, then you're nothing. Right? Wrong.
Right.
Okay. Influence. How can you influence them? Paano mo may influence? How can you influence the other new players? Single-minded. No matter what, my objective is to what? To win the game.
Win the game.
To progress into number 2 and eventually number 1. So you don't believe in all things that come across your way, that criticism in all those things, the negative things that you hear, the negative things that they show you. Just focus. That is our life as soldiers. we have to learn to accept the negative things that happen in our life. Even when you're asleep already, you get about it. You don't have it. It's my philosophy in life. If I sleep, I'm gonna sleep. I seldom sleep. But I don't want to sleep with problems because I can leave it. If I have problem, I look for a solution. If I don't have the solution, I will not think of the problem. Why should I think of the problem? I do not. Now, if I find a solution now, I go back to the problem. Do you understand? Do you follow?
Yes.
Probably you have different way of thinking. See, my tanong, question. Very important to ask. Oh, Simon, you know this. All right. Again, we go back to organization. So organization is one of the most important things in your training. Important factor that is some training of the teams. Here again, at some point, you can't really reach your objective or your goals in that particular training. So what will you do the next time? Probably you adjust a detail. You plan again. For you to really achieve or get to the point of your achieve that objective. By what? Revising your plan a little. The same objective. But don't sort out to go to the other subject. No! You have to finish that problem. Don't abandon that. A problem in all is always a problem. It will never end. If you don't want to have problems, it will close. Number of players, practice area, equipment. Then, of course, the facilities that we have. So, can you handle 30 players, 8 years old? You get. So, what do you mean? So if that is the case again, no matter how many goals you have, you have to make a device, allow them to play because you cannot handle 38 years old, 7 years old, 3 years old at a time. Let them play. You yellow, you green, go there. Play there, 5 versus 5. Or 3 versus 3 or 4 versus 4. You can't do anything about it. Now, if you don't have enough space for the 30, players that we have. So watch and sit. Then after a few hours, a few minutes, they play again. You can only accommodate 10 or 12, then we have to sit. What? It says, we play, you rest, I rest, we rest, you play. Things like that. Right? But if you have a system, probably it will change that later on that training. But still, it's too much, no? 15, bad enough. You can already have it. Right? So, practice area, I said, probably it's too small. It's not fit for 30. Players. So what will you do? Again, think of what? The second? Or the plan? B. What if I don't have enough? Because the venue was changed. Instead of the turf, move to Munabe. Or instead of Munabe, you will move again to. Oh, you're very happy. Huh? No? Then again, the problem there is number one is really you have to come early, prepare for your plan, set up the because it's easy to pick up those markers if only a few arrive. But if you expect only 8 and 15 arrive, then you have a problem. So you must come early. Kaya, punctuality is is a thing or is it? What is the difference of coming to the practice that is ready? If I leave my place to be in the, to be in the training of the Kotlak, I leave 7:40. Also, along the way, I might meet an accident. Or I got traffic, I trap in the traffic. So I can still have enough time to go. Traveling in the taxi or in the bus. No, I have only 700 pesos. So what? That's part of life in coaching. Don't tell me you have only, and you will die there. How about the children will be for you there? Things like that. You must come, you must go. No other option. Consideration, sample start, point of the practice. How do you start? Where do you start? Who will start? How do you start is how do you what? Here again you have a challenge. You challenge yourself? Who will start? I mean, bring to side of the ball? Or Ryan who? Games or what? So all those things already set, planned before you come to the practice. You're just waiting to what? To execute the or to run the training or practice. And if you have a system, you're lucky enough. But if you don't have them, go ahead with your plan. Try to do your best. Alright. Development of the practice. What do you mean by that? Development of the practice. How do you develop your training? By what? By what? Involving them in your plan if possible. By telling him what? Because the last time he had, he don't understand what are you trying to achieve. You can only achieve this thing if the players, the coaches know what is your objective. And they know how to start. You know who gotta start. Even the time frame of your training. As I said, how many minutes kanina yung a while ago, we talk about the warm-up, lead-up drills, 3v3, 4v4, small-sided games, and then the cool-down. How many minutes is that? Warm-up, 20 minutes. Remember that? The whole calling off or calling down exercises. 10 minutes plus what?
Breathing.
Breathing. What is it? What is the thing you do after your train?
Feedback.
After the whole up, the calling down.
Feedback.
Feedback. Short breathing or short what? Reminders. Tomorrow, practice will be in McKinley, not here in Molabe. You understand? Bring with you your water. You don't bring water. You want to clean yourself here.
Yeah.
So bring water with you. Okay, somebody forget that. Then somebody forget their shipyard. Somebody forget their water. Or sometimes they even forget their sapatos, their shoes. So you should remind them because they are not adult. Again and again, he must be reminded. Even the parents. Mom said, your son will get his son. All right? Physical condition. The coach also being ideal, sorry. You have to be physically fit also. Not like the players. Yesterday I was supposed to have a stress test. So I came to the doctor and he said that I'm not fit because I have just got a stroke. It's like stroke. Yes. So I insist that he says something. And I'll sign a waiver on the way. Allow me. Just like me, I hope the player wants to, but I don't want it. So, any body who goes to coaching anybody who goes to train to be physically a player or even a player. You must comply with that requirement. That is a requirement. Not only you are there present, not only you are there, you do everything. But you can't perform that task as a coach. Any question, any objection, whatever. Do you understand that we go fast because maybe demonstration and simulation? How? How do you induce an effect? By what? Showing good blood. Demonstration. Giving them good or logical way of feeding them the coaching point. Sometimes we do giving them points on what we are going to do. You know, sometimes things that we did right, don't do anything about it anymore. Just only the thing that we can't do it, why we can't do it. So how do you do it? With your guidance, with your knowledge. Yeah? Do you follow?
Good.
Don't put something which is already there. Don't overdo it. Right? Probably you don't. Okay. I want to see faster. I want to see speed. I want to see quick turning with the outside of the foot. Left and right. But sometimes we can't do it. So you challenge them. You can't do it. You must do it. We must do it. Challenge to play, yeah, bigger performance. Use of your voice. Sometimes you know when to. Lower your voice. And you know when to go up. You know how to modulate your voice so you can be understood, or you can be participant. You see that, right? So they can understand. You get the attention of every individual. Now there is some of you who I observe who gather the voice to give instruction, but some of the boys are settled. Some of the boys are talking to each other. Some of the boys are not even close to you. That is common, even with myself. Be aware of that. Don't give instruction with one or two of them are not ready. Ready means they should be there listening. They should be there in good position that they can hear and see you. You follow? Then give only one or two words or three words. I want you to be quick and fast. Be aggressive. And depending, it's like that. Don't allow to be anymore. Just go direct to the point. Do you follow? Do you understand?
It's good.
So again, the most important thing is that everybody can see you. And you see everybody. And another thing, the position of your players in your position. Sometimes the sun are here, sometimes it's up here. The host is here in the shadow. The players are there in the, no, you change. Right? Allow them to occupy. And sometimes the crowd is here, the parents are here. No, position yourself here. Let them stay there in front of their parent or the crowd. You stay. Then the distance, be sure that you can be here. Be sure that we can see you. And when you address the players, make it the point that you see eye to eye with him, but don't intimidate. Sometimes they are intimidated by us. You're looking straight in his face or in his eyes, that intimidate them. No. Be understanding with them. Okay? Oh, use of always hear another one. Appearance. How do we appear in the faith? How? With what? With in the professional when they arrived, I went to Germany. The professional, the hostess, from Taiwan. With
next
time. They arrive, go to the locker room, they change the shirts. What about the hostess? Same. Much. Then when they get out, they're already only playing this. But what about the Filipino coaches and the sporting coaches? How do we present ourselves in the training? We parents all over the place. Number one, you must be there on time.
Okay.
I don't know if Coach Simon, how he ruled that. If the practice is at 4 o'clock, you must be there at least 3:30. For me. But in international competition, if you are having the national team, you must be there 2 hours prior to the match. Because this is what we call that. Time. Here in us, in VGC or in Makini, we must not be. Then you have to welcome the players, yeah. So, how are you? Chris, how are you? Irene? Alright, you welcome them. Don't see your face that you are sad or you are, you know. Keep to them that you are ready to defend them. You are there, because of them, that you're going to have the training. But do that, you know, you don't even save your, I'm not telling you, you have to save your success or whatever you like. But you have to be prepared for that. Even when you have wearing the collars, and so there, so that you are also. Can we do that? Moses, yes. Simon, can we do that? Or no? You want that? I come only if I want to?
95
Oh, one day I got late. Once in life in that hearing, I got to the traffic because it's my car. So actually, along the highway in traffic. So I was asleep for 1 minute or 2 minutes. Because I arrive all the time in the area, at least 30, at the very late 15 minutes.
Never late.
Just in mind that I already know what
but I can have a lot of traffic.
Right? So you have to be ready.
It's a BBC, you have to park.
And sometimes there will be some sort of adjustment because the other club is in there, the security guard are not allowing us to. So you follow, do you understand? And one day I got mad in my for myself because Simon texted me about the markers in the home, so I never have that. You know my attitude out there before the practice. Even wherever I go, even the ball is safe in Molave. I mean, you have a ball, we love balls. The best is to be brought to that. The spot of our job. There's no one else. They put it to the side. Because right now we don't have a kit man or groundsman to help us with that. So, we have to be patient. We have to be understanding about the speed of things. Still, at the end of the day, if something happened with the equipment, play whatever, we're part of it. We are responsible. Okay! So, appearance, huh? Like today, you know, it rains in Quezon City this morning. Oh, last night he was working with the presentation. So sad because when I got here, the computer will not work with that. Coming up, it's the whatever.
Forget.
I'm happy enough, I came early. So we were able to secure things for us. Alright. Tomorrow we eat. The next tomorrow we eat. After a while we eat. I think we're awesome. Alright. Hi, good afternoon, man. Okay. Two slides lang. It's hard to come back again. Observation allowed practice to run, to close. Again, I already explained that a while ago. I repeat it again. You do the practice, you start the practice, allow at least 1-2 minutes, at least 2 minutes or 3 minutes to stop the practice. Allow them to what? To feel the atmosphere. Okay?
That's good.
To manage themselves, adapting to that. Especially when you are in different areas to do like this. Alright? Be single-minded. Don't mind the sticks on the sides. Just focus on what is your objective of practice. Don't believe in it because you already have done. If you listen, you will be distracted with what they have, what you want. Then you can progress with that because you are already carrying a big baggage. Though, probably before the practice can be done, it can be done. But you already started. Go ahead. That's what he meant by single-minded. Next is seek out key factors, KCF. What does it mean? Key coaching points. That coaching points of yours, the things that you are that you have in mind in your head, should be established or concretized in your mind that this is it. My only advice, don't give coaching points as many as you can, as if you are taking the horse. No, only the things that you see, only the things that the player committed, a mistake that you have to correct. Don't correct something which is wrong, or which is right. Do you follow? Do you understand? What do you want, huh? Are you angry? I know I got lasted for 2 days, 3 days. Okay. Coach players, not good. Don't coach your 4-3-3 or 3-5-2 or 2-6-2. Coach the player. Don't coach passing. Coach the player. What does it mean? Coach what is the need of that?
Yes.
But not the needs of the players. Don't coach them. You are football that you read last night in the book. Oh, this is Sir Alex style of coaching the team. Don't follow them. Coach your boys. What do you think is good for him? What do you think can be better? Again, the objective of every coaching session is to what? To develop the boys. Not develop football by themselves. With the assistance of the boys, of your players. But you push them in accordance to their needs. Okay?
Good.
Correct errors. Now, how do we correct errors? When you see a mistake, don't allow it to flow. The more, stop! Then you can push. Stop. Stay where you are. How did it happen? Question and answer. Why did it happen? Allow them to what? To answer. Why did it happen? Why did it, Ramon? Where were you? What is your position? Then you try to what?
Try to what?
Correct the mistake by feeding them the
points
you want to. Don't just tell them on. Then you do the repetition. For instance, the pass is too slow. The opponent from behind was able to what? To intercept the pass. So the weight of the pass. So let him pass again. Oh, you got it. Good. Another one. Two. Go there again. Another one. Three. Then play. You follow, you understand.
Good.
Why you have to repeat it one? 2, 3. Because of what? Principle of
repetition.
Repetition. You do it again and again and again until you get that. You take it. You follow?
Okay.
Those principles, that
situation.
Do you understand that? So you can do what? Principles, what? The science behind the things you're doing, support play, angle of the pass, how you control with the chest, your body position, your leg, right, your eyes, your hands, your arms, and everything.
Break na tayo, guys.
Shake it.
Shake it.